Working at the White House for a couple years, I had the opportunity to travel with President Obama on a few Air Force One trips. And the most interesting was when he went to give the awards and got the debriefing from the team that did the raid on Bin Laden. And a couple of things struck me about that trip. One was when he was giving the team their awards, the team really didn't understand why they were getting all the attention. They said that the credit should go elsewhere to either the helicopter pilots or the intelligence professionals. The other thing that struck me is that the president made a remark on our way home that what he was struck by was the humility of the team leader. That when he got the debrief, the team leader stepped aside and let the team debrief the operation and he didn't take credit. The other thing he said is he was really struck by the pronouns the team used. They spoke only in terms of we and us. And that's the thing about humility. We know it's effective and we know why it's effective in leadership. Because humble leaders believe in their fallibility, they believe they need the judgment and the wisdom of their teams, and they leverage that to great effect. More importantly, they celebrate others, they celebrate the team, which really drives the team's motivation and creativity, which of course increases productivity further. But the crazy thing is we don't celebrate heroic or humble leaders. We don't love humble leaders. We love heroic leaders. We gravitate towards heroic leaders.